Hello students, so in today's class we are going to discuss about the remaining data types. So already in the previous classes we have discussed about numbers and sequence data types. So when you consider the number data type, you have int, float, complex number followed by boolean data types in number data type, whereas in sequence you have strings, list and tuples. So we have discussed all these things in the previous classes, and now we are going to discuss about the other data types like sets, none and mapping. So first we'll discuss about mapping. So sets and mappings together we will make use of in the concept dictionary. So these are both these data types comes in the concept dictionary. So regarding this dictionary concept, you will study in depth in the later chapter. Now we will just discuss what is meant by dictionary. So mapping, when you consider, it is an unordered data type in Python, and there is only one standard mapping data type in Python, which is called the dictionary. So if you see the dictionary as much similar to the word dictionary, what do you mean? You will search, you will refer to some meanings based on the keywords, right? Using the keywords, you will refer to the meaning in the dictionary. So much similar to that, the dictionary concept in Python, you will define all the values in the dictionary in the key value pass. So if you look at sequences, if you look at the list and tuples, you will define different data types inside the square brackets or inside the parentheses, right? When you consider list, you will enclose all the values, that is all the data items, in a square bracket, whereas in tuples you will enclose all the data items inside the parentheses. When you consider dictionary, you will enclose all the items inside the curly braces. Clear? And the data items which you give in the dictionary will be in the form of key value pairs. So key value pairs, which is like this only. If you look at this example here, see fruit, which is which acts like a key, and apple, which is the value. So in this form only you will define all the values in dictionary. Whereas in list and tuples, if you consider, you can give any kind of data types within the brackets or within the parentheses. So that is completely different. So in the dictionary you will provide all the data items in the form of key value pairs. Clear? So this helps you to access all the data much faster when compared to other data types. So that's why this is much preferable. So when it comes to key value pairs, every key is separated from its value using a colon sign. If you look at these key value pairs, each and every item, so this entire thing is considered as one data, that is one item. So both these key and value will be separated by colon. Similarly, climate and cold, it is separated by colon. So price kg and 120, which is separated by colon. So this key value pairs of a dictionary, it can be accessed using the key. So using the key, that is for example price of kg, climate and fruit, all these things are keys, right? So using the key only you will access the respective values which belong to the respective key. And when you are defining the key value pairs, you have to keep one more thing in your mind, which is the keys which you give should be of the string data type alone. So most probably it will be of the string data type, whereas the values which you give can be of any data type. So there is no restriction for providing the values. So how, like if you consider a list and tuples, how you can provide any kind of data type and data items inside the brackets, much similar to that, values can be of any type, whereas the keys which you provide should be of string data type. So when you try to access, if in case if you need to access any value from the dictionary which you have provided, you have to access it using the key. So let us see how to access using the key. Now for example, dictionary 1, so any variable you can provide, it is not a compulsion that you have to provide only dictionary of 1. So fruit colon apple, so fruit, it is of string type, which is the key, and climate, it is of string type, which is the key again. So price of kg is the key again of string data type, and values can be of any type. If you see here, apple is of string type, again this is of cold is of string type, and 120, it is of integer type. Clear? So now we have defined a dictionary. So I'm going to print the entire key value pairs using the variable dictionary 1. So I can give it using print of dictionary 1. If I give it like this, what will happen? The entire dictionary gets printed, and you have to enclose all the values inside the curly braces. So like how you enclose all the data items in list using the square brackets, and in tuples you will enclose everything in the parentheses. So much similar to that, here you will use the curly braces. And if you wanted to access the specific value using the respective key, what you have to do is you have to enclose it. Enclose the key in the square brackets. So let us see how to do that. Print off dictionary 1 using the variable. So only by using the variable name followed by the key enclosing in square bracket, you can access the value. I'll repeat again. So you have to make use of the variable name to access the value, but to access the respective value, you have to use the respective key within the square bracket. So from the dictionary 1 variable, I wanted to access the value 120. So the respective key I have to give here is price of kg, which I have to enclose within square brackets. So this is the actual syntax which you have to follow. When you give it like this, the value 120 will be retrieved. So this is how you will create a dictionary and you will retrieve value from the dictionary using the key. Now let us see the other concept, Boolean data type. So Boolean data type, it is a sub type of the integer data type that we have discussed already. And Boolean data type, if you consider, it will return only two different values, either true or false. So true represents one or a non-zero value, and then false represents zero or a zeroth value. Yes, so this you can consider, which is even the false value you can even consider as an empty or a null value. Clear. So Boolean data type, it represents only one of the two possible conditions, and always the Boolean results, the values, this true and false will always be represented with capital T and capital F. Always the result will be returned in this form. It will not be returned as true and false with small letters. Only the very first letter will be represented with capital letter to differentiate from the other words which you use in the programming language. That is the reason. So just look at this example, Boolean 1. So any variable you can give here. It is not that you have to give only Boolean underscore 1, which is equal to 6 greater than 10. So true or false values, when they will return the value true or false, only when you come under a comparison, you will get the values either true or false. So they will make use of the comparison operators. So 6 greater than 10, they are checking here. The condition is false, obviously. So when you try to print this using the variable, using the Boolean variable along with the print function, it will return the value false. I'll show you one more example using the shell environment. So just a minute. Okay, so here instead of Boolean 2, I'm going to give the variable as a, which is equal to, within brackets I'm going to check, which is 10 less than or equal to 20, the same which I'm going to give, and just press enter. And if I try to print the variable a, what will happen here is it will return the result true. So you can use any variable, there is no restrictions. Just for your understanding, they have given here as Boolean 1 and Boolean 2. So it will return the result as true, as it is less than 20, and the value which is returned, the T will be represented in capital for the Boolean values true and false. If it is going to be false, the value will be returned with capital F. Clear. Now let us see the next data type, which is none. So none means it is also a special data type. So when it will define a null value, or it will define no value at all. That's why we make use of a none data type. So when you don't want to specify any values, or if you don't want to specify any conditions, so you can make you at that time you can make use of this none data type. So when you see this none data type can be assigned to any variables. So see here, value 1 equal to 20. So this 20 is a value which has been assigned to value 1 variable, and for the value 2 variable they have assigned the none data type. So when you assign this none data type, it can be assigned to any variable. So when you assign to this, it will not display anything when you retrieve this variable. It will just display nothing, or it will display as none. So for this purpose only we will make use of this none data type. Clear. You see here, value 1 has been retrieved. I have told you, using the print statement or without using the print statement, you can print the values. So value 1, if I call here, 20 gets printed. Value 2, if I call here, it will not display anything because there is no value. That's why we have given none. We have assigned a none to the variable value 2. Alternatively, you can even print it using the print statement. So print of value 2, if I'm going to give, the same none will be displayed. Now we are going to discuss about type. So this is the second component of a variable. So we have discussed three components in a variable. One is identity, type, and then value. So regarding identity, we have discussed a lot, and then now we are going to discuss about type, which is the second component of a variable. So type represents, already we have discussed the particular variable belongs to what data type. So when you wanted to find out the value which you have given belongs to which data type, or the variable which you have created belongs to what data type, you can make use of this type function. So I'll tell you how to make use of this type function. Just look at this example. Now type of 10, they have directly given a value inside the type function. So type parenthesis, that is the actual syntax for the type function, and inside the parenthesis they have given a value. So 10 belongs to the integer data type. So what will happen, it will return the result as class int. It belongs to the integer data type, so this is the result. So if I'm going to give, see here, type of 3.5, if I'm going to give, it will return the result as float, because it contains a fractional part, so obviously it will return the result as float. Similarly, 22/7 they have given here. 22/7, it will divide, and it will find one more thing. I'll repeat the statement. See, type of 3.5 I have given, in case I'm going to enclose within the quotes, see the result. It will display the result as class str, because whatever value or any symbols or numbers that you enclose within the quotes, what will happen, that will be considered as a string, and it will return it as the string data type. So much similar to that, they have given many examples here. Hello Python, which has been given as a string, so string will be returned. And type of true, so when you are giving true and false keywords, it is considered as the keyword. Actually, this true and false is the keyword which is already there in Python, so we will study about the keywords later. So true, which represents the boolean value, so it will return the data type as boolean, and false also belongs to the boolean data type, so it will return the result as boolean. And even when you try to use the comparison operator, see here, if I'm going to give 8 greater than 5, much similar to what you have here, it will return the result as boolean, because it is comparing. 8 is greater than 5, the answer is true, so it is makes use of the comparison operator, which comes under the boolean data type. You understood? So this is how you can make use of the type function. And even this type function can be alternatively used using the variables. So here directly they have given the values inside the type function, but you can assign the values to a variable, and then you can call this. For example, if I'm going to give 8.52 for the variable A, and if I wanted to find out it belongs to what data type, I can give as type of A. So I have assigned a value to the variable A, and now I'm retrieving the variable A. So if I press enter, it will display the result as float. So this is the alternative method where you can check the result, or you can work with the type function. Either directly you can give the values, or you can assign values to a variables, and you can call that variable inside the type function. So much similar to that, they have given the other respective examples here. See, 10 has been assigned to the variable x, and they have called the variable x inside the type function, which belongs to integer data type. Similarly, floating point type, so string data type. So the respective examples you can see and understand from this screen. Now we are going to discuss about value. So this is the third component of a variable. So identity we have discussed, type we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss about value of a variable. So value means when will you assign a value to a variable? If you wanted to create a variable, what will you do? You will assign a value to a variable. A equal to 10, if I'm going to give, A is the variable and 10 is the value, right? So if I'm going to assign 10 to the variable A, how I will assign? Using the assignment operator. So which is the assignment operator here? equal to is the assignment operator. So without equal to, you cannot assign any values to variables. If you see here, so max equal to 87 they have given. So 87 is the value, max is the variable, name of the variable. See here, max is the name of the variable and 87 is the value of the variable. So I have assigned the value 87 to the variable max using the assignment operator. So this is how you will assign a value. So that's why value of the variable can also be called as object. And this process is also termed as the building of a variable. So in Python, unless you assign a value to a variable will not get created. So that is what they have given here. A variable is not created until some value is assigned to it. And the values are also called objects. And one more thing, a variable should always be on the left hand side and the value should always takes only the right hand side. So if you try to give 87 equal to max, this will result in error. So you have to follow up the rules when you write all the codings. Now let us discuss about this L value and R value. So L value and R value, if you consider, which is nothing but left hand side value and right side value. So much similar to the variables and the value which you have discussed already. So if you consider the left hand side, in the left hand side of the assignment operator, to the left hand side of this assignment operator equal to, you can have only one variable over there. But to the right hand side of the assignment operator, you can have any valid expression or you can have any respective values. Clear? So towards the left hand side, you can have only one variable. If I'm going to define x is equal to a plus b, so x is the variable which I have in the left hand side and a plus b is the expression which I have given on the right hand side. So you have to follow up this format when you're giving some expressions using the assignment operator. So this expression is called the L value or left value, or even you can call it as R value or right value. Now multiple assignments. So what is meant by multiple assignments? In Python, one more thing is possible, which is the multiple assignments, which is not like other programming languages, which is not possible in other programming languages, first of all. So it will help you to enhance the readability of your program for all these things. So multiple assignments in Python can be done in two ways. One is you can assign multiple values to multiple variables, or you can assign same value to multiple variables. That is, see here, variable 1, 2, 3 equal to value 1, value 2, value 3. So if you look at this example, you will understand message, comma day, comma time equal to meeting, comma Monday, comma 9, which means multiple values to multiple variables. In the same place, I can assign multiple variables, and for this multiple variables, I can assign the respective values in the same line itself. I don't have to type in the next line. So message, based on the priority, all the values will be assigned to the variables. So for message, the value is meeting, and for day the value is Monday, and for time the value is 9. Similarly, if you consider x and y, so for the variable x the value is 2 and for the variable y the value is 3. So according to the priority, all the values will be assigned. I'll show you an example in the Python shell environment. For example, see here, x comma y equal to 2 comma 5. If I'm going to give, what will happen if I'm trying to print x? Trying to print the value of x, it will print the value of x alone, because directly it will assign the value 2 to x. If I try to print the value of y, only the value of y gets printed. But if I wanted to add x plus y, I can directly give this expression over here also. Can you see the difference? So x plus y can be directly added here and it will display the result 7. So this much user friendly is Python. So it allows you to enhance readability of the program and it saves your time in a single line of code. And assigning same value to multiple variables. So same value to multiple variables means, look at the syntax, variable 1 equal to 2 equal to 3, which is equal to, only one value they will assign to all the variables. That is, total marks equal to count equal to 0 means the 0 is applicable for total marks variable as well as for count variable. So this is how it works. Clear? Now let us discuss a few examples related to that. See, x, y, z and p is equal to 240, 34.5 and Vinay. So x will take the value 2, y will take the value 40, z will take the value 34.5 and p will take the value Vinay. So this is how it works. So directly even you can add, if I give x plus y, what is x plus y? 2 plus 40, which is 42. Similarly, x minus y, if I'm going to give, it will take the greater number sign. So 2 minus 40, which is minus 38. Similarly, assigning multiple value, assigning same value to multiple variables. If you look at this example, see the same value minus 55 has been assigned to multiple variables, a equal to b equal to c. So all these variables will contain the same value, minus 55. If I try to print this a, b, c, everything will be for all the variables, it will display the same value, minus 55, minus 55, minus 55. If I try to add, it will add all these things together and it will display the value minus 165. So this is how it will work. So regarding the data types, component of a variable or type, then none data type, boolean and dictionary we have discussed in today's class. Let us discuss about the rules for variables in the next class. So I hope you understood the class, children. Thank you.